Good morning, teachers and friends. Today I would like to draw your attention to Sun Sisumun, a very famous singer of Cambodia. He was born in 1932 in Sankang Province. He was very active from 1950 to 1970, and he died in 1976. He got married twice. First he married his cousin through the arrangement of their parents. This union produced four children, a daughter and three sons. Second, he married a royal ballet dancer. After his marriage, his wife became a Buddhist monk. Sun Sisumun showed interest in music since he was five. He attended elementary school at the age of seven, and he would be asked to perform at the school function. After completing high school, he moved to study at the medical school in Phnom Penh. Besides studying, he still managed to have the time to work as a singer and a songwriter in order to earn money to cover his school expenses. At the time, he met many artists and he could learn how to become a professional singer. Based on his soft pitch and low, heavy, tolerant voice, he began to become popular very quickly. He was known as a unique singer who never ended his searching for the music. He tried to sing a song while he was lifting weights every morning. He could sing all kinds of the songs, like traditional, ancient, and pop, with clear action, and could follow the rhyme and rhythm very well. He sang more than 1,000 songs independently and associated with other singers. He was very serious in writing songs and composing. Sometimes he used many dictionaries to find the right word for the song. He enjoyed his song to be very emotional and to translate his feeling or the audience feeling, like pain, love, sorrow, or regret. For each time he went abroad with His Majesty the King, he always used to write a song about his great time there. He used mandolin or guitar to search for the new rhythm. After France granted independence to Cambodia in 1953, he became a regular singer on the national radio live broadcasting. At the time, his popularity spread over the country. Unfortunately, when his family heard his voice on the radio, they were not satisfied because they wanted him to be a doctor, not a singer. And they were worried that his music might disturb his studying. In 1955, Her Majesty the Queen asked him to work for the royal band, and he sang at the royal reception and the state function. During this period, his popularity and prestige increased, and he was considered by far the best singer in the nation. No one came close to even being considered second best. 1 year after Khmer Rouge occupied the country, he was killed in Kandahar province because he failed to write a song which satisfied Khmer Rouge leader. Sun Sisumun was a great emperor of Khmer music, and he was a pride to Cambodia. His achievements are unforgettable. Though he passed away, his song lived and is very popular. So I wish all new generation singers will follow him to be the best singer they can possibly be. Thank you very much for your kind attention.